and solutions. Shri Hardik Shah, a chartered accountant, has a 10-year post-qualification experience in indirect tax. At present, he is providing his services as a senior manager at Deloitte Ahmedabad for indirect tax matters. He looks after indirect tax planning and regulatory matters. He has handled special assignments including tax planning and compliance of all indirect taxes, representation before various departmental and appellate authorities. But in spite of his busy professional commitments, Hardik Bhai finds out time for academics too. He is a part-time faculty with National.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Ms. Gausar, for a short and sweet introduction. Before I start, I would just like to mention that I was one of you a decade before. I used to be from HL, was attending almost all of such sessions whenever I was available. And it's good to be on the other side of the table after a decade or so. So it's a pleasure moment for me more than you, because I am interacting with such a huge crowd, and that too one of us only. So I am very happy. Before I and I'm very thankful for HL College of Commerce to give me this opportunity. So I'll with regards to the invitation provided by HL College, respected Patak sir, Dr. Kalra, Mona ma'am, and all other faculties, I have been given the opportunity to discuss the topic with respect to the issues, the implementation and the solution from a GST perspective. So I am thankful to Sri Nayan Sheth, who helped us with respect to providing an overview of the GST. So what I understand from a GST perspective is that a tax is levied on a supplier. What is a supply? Right. So Nayan Bhai explained us in very detail what is supply, but to me, if I have to term it in one word, it is a change in possession. Any change in possession is a supply. It will attract a tax. Now there are certain exceptions to it, right? But in simple, even a change of, let us say, if I give a pen to anybody, that will also be termed as a supply, which ideally should be liable to GST. Now, the topic which I have been given has been bifurcated into two main parts. I will be covering most of the sector-specific implications and certainly the issues which are still there in the GST and the solutions to those issues wherever feasible. Now, GST, right, people have given a lot of names to it. Some tells it as a good and a simple tax, some say it as a Gabbar Singh tax, and there are n number of taxes. Right. It is, to the best of my understanding, we keep it as goods and service tax, that's good enough, because it is nowhere near to good and simple tax, one, though they have attempted it, and it is certainly not to the extent of a Gabbar Singh tax. So, after an overview, whatever we have learned from the earlier session, let us look upon the fact that where all it impacts the most. So, I have covered a few sectors. And if you will be able to see the slides, I will be covering most of the sectors, starting with pharma. Now, pharma in particular as an industry works in a specified manner, and most of the industries work in a unique manner. They have their own sets of issues and own sets of problems. So here, in the case of pharma, what usually happens is that India in general is the top manufacturing country with respect to bulk drugs, the basic bulk drugs, but we are not that great with respect to formulations. So when we talk about the medicines like metacin and all other, right, we are the best, right, we manufacture at the lowest of the cost across the globe. But when we talk about the likes of Lipitor, right, which happens to be one of the best selling drug across the world, the only medicine which has the turnover greater than the companies taken together, right, we are not among the best. We are trying to, but we are not among the best at this point of time. Now, how it operates as an industry is the fact that the manufacturing facility would be at one location. However, the agents would have been appointed at different states wherein the goods would be distributed, and those agents would in turn distribute it to the hospitals, to the dealers, and it will follow through the retail chain to the consumer. Now, because of the fact that there was a CST which was there earlier, the central sales tax, which ideally was not a creditable tax, this creation of branches, warehouses and a state-specific model was generated. And the generation of this state-specific model was coined none other than by the Hindustan Unilever then, which was
our invitation and addressing the inaugural function. I am also very much thankful to all the expert speakers, C.A. Shri Dinabhai Shah, C.A. Shri Gaurabhai Shah, Shri Nayanbhai Sheth, and C.A. Shri Hardik Shah for sharing their knowledge on the topic and taking time of their busy schedules. I am also grateful to all our esteemed guests and invitees for gracing the function with their presence. We are very much thankful to Ahmedabad Education Society, Professor Dr. Kandro Sir, C.A. Shri B.M. Shah Sir, for their patronage, constant support. Without your generous support, it would not have been possible to organize this conference. I'm sure you will continue to get the same support in future also. I'm very much thankful to Principal Dr. Mona Ma'am, and once again Kandro Sir, for giving me an opportunity to organize this conference. Ma'am and Sir, your inspiring mentorship, continued support and advice have greatly helped me in organizing this conference very successfully. I acknowledge the unwavering support received from all my colleagues who are here since morning, early morning, staff member, that is entire HM team. I would like to make a very special mention of Dr. Parag Shah, who helped me at every stage in organizing this conference. Thank you very much, Parag. I am thankful to all the principals, faculties, delegates, research scholars and students having confidence in us that we would be able to provide them academic first and so for their enthusiastic participation in the conference. We are also thankful to the sponsors BSR Prakashan and Sudhir Prakashan for their generous financial support. Last but not the least, I thank all the volunteers for their unconditional help. I say to Shruti Nair, who helped me a lot in offline registration from the day one. So thank you very much, Shruti. Once again, thank you to all of you. Now I invite Vaidehi, and I request all of you, please rise in your places for the national anthem.